He's got a very, very famous father. He's got a very, very famous grandfather he sees every single Wednesday. And now Cameron Douglas has a really big book. It is called Long Way Home. It's nice to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
And I tell you what, your name has been in the news off and on for a long time, but generally not for reasons I suspect you would want.
True.
You got out of Danbury when?
June of 2016.
And you were incarcerated for how long?
Close to 8 years.
Mm. Wow. Yeah. And when you say that, how does it sound to you?
It was a journey. It was a journey. But I feel like I made the most of it in the ways that you can in a situation like that. And it gave me an opportunity to begin writing this book, which I hope will be useful.
You know what? That's a very good phrase. I think it is useful, and you clearly put your heart and soul into this book. And I think a lot of people would think, and you tell me, blessing or burden to have Michael Douglas as my dad, Kurt Douglas as my granddad?
Well, you know, my father always used to say, and I think it's very true, he'd say, there's a lot of good things that come with being from a famous family, and there's some drawbacks, but you hope the good things outweigh the drawbacks. And I think in most cases, that's very true. However, in prison, not so much. But
is that right?
Well, there's that, but it's not an environment where that's going to be helpful for you.
In any particular way.
Right.
You detail problems with heroin and a variety of other things in really searing detail. In one sense I have, it's like you're trapped that you can't get out.
Well, you know, the idea, I mean, I poured my heart and soul into this book, and I bare my soul in the effort to connect with people. And I think the only way to do that, I've found, is to be brutally honest, so that people that are going through similar things can relate. And, you know, I can't go back and change the past, but what I can do is try to take some of those experiences and hopefully turn them into something that could be helpful.
You're the father of a 2-year-old daughter.
I do, a beautiful little 2-year-old girl.
Congratulations
to
you. How do you prevent her from having the experiences you've had?
Well, for starters, her mother is a yogi, and she's tough as nails, and she's very evolved. So we just kind of, we follow suit. And, you know, I've learned from my parents. You know, my parents did a lot of great things with me. And I've learned from some of the things, the mistakes that they've made. And I will just try to do the best that I can.
Your father, and you include this in the book, wrote you a note at one point. And I want to share with people the note that he wrote that you include in the book. And here's what he writes to you. Hey, Cam, so what have you been up to lately? Thank you for your letter and apology. Your whole family's heart goes out to you. We're not embarrassed. We love you. Just feel it's a hard road that you've chosen. Mm. Talk to me about receiving that note.
Oh, well, that was at the very beginning of my sojourn through prison. And so there was just so much going on in my mind. I don't even think I really grasped, you know, what I had in front of me at that point yet. But I felt a lot of shame. And I wanted to express to my family, although words at a time like that don't do much justice. But as you can see, you know, they were always supportive of me, and I think that helped a lot to bring me through in the way that I came through it all.
You're gonna have an opportunity to meet Cameron. He is signing copies of his new memoir, Long Way Home. He'll do it tomorrow night at Book Soup on Sunset. Signing starts at 4 p.m. Information at the website booksoup.com. Good luck to you, Cameron. Thanks
so
much.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
Quick break here, and we'll come right back.
Thank you. It feels better than this.